Hello all, welcome to Global Offensive Hacker Associate community and welcome to another hacking episode of Hacker Associate. In this video, we are going to see how to perform web application penetration testing. So here I have a popular course. Okay, you can simply go to the training section and here it is. You can go to the advanced web application pen testing. That course you can explore. And today I'm going to give you a demo, okay, how to exploit web application. And today we are going to learn how to exploit a GitLab vulnerability. So let's start. So right now I'm going to the Kali machine. Let me enter my username and then password. And here you can see this is my Kali box. Okay. So now when you go to my terminal and I'm pinging up to this machine 10.10.10.220, and it is pinging, and you can see TTL is 63. It means it is a Linux operating system. So TTL 63 means Linux TTL more than 63, like 128. It will be a window. So let's start. So what I can do here is, okay, like I'll start nmap scanning. So the basic thing is when you want to penetrate any application, you need to start scanning. So there are basically five phases which I am using. And using that five phases, I am exploiting okay any kind of application. The first is information gathering, second is vulnerability analysis, deep vulnerability analysis, fourth is a payload, and fifth is a exploit. Now, this part is very basic. Okay, you can simply just go here nmap minus v minus s capital V minus A minus P minus. It means all port scanning, aggressive scanning, and version detection, and the IP whatever you want, like 10.10.10.220. That command, okay, you can press enter. Once you press enter, it'll take a little bit time and you will be seeing okay two port open there. So one is this. So one port okay is 5080, which is basically the web port, and 22, which is SSH. So two ports are open okay in this particular system. Now what I can do here is I can simply go here and open my browser. Okay, and then try to check this particular port 5080. Let's start. So I'm opening my browser. Once it opens, then okay, we'll check it. Okay, like what exactly on this particular web page. So if you can check here, okay, this section, okay, I just simple just type 10.10.10.220 and our port is 5080. When you press enter, let's see what will be coming here. So here you can see the proxy server is refusing a connection. So it's better, okay, like it's a web port. So it'll better restart the burp switch. So let me start the burp. So I'll just go here and search the burp. This is a burp switch comment edition. So I have a two edition, okay. In Kali, I'm using a community edition, and outside, okay, this is my Mac system, I'm using a professional version. So first you can open your burp. You can simply go here next. Next start burp. So recently in the professional edition, okay, like the burp have added logger, and this I'm going to record a video shortly, maybe this week, and I'm going to upload on YouTube. So you can please check it out. How to use logger in the burp suite. Okay, so now you can see this is the proxy section and here's the intercept is off. Okay, and now when I go to the browser and you can see this is my burp and the burp is running. Fantastic. Now you can simply refresh this page and let's see what exactly on this particular page. So when you open this particular page, you can see like you're able to see GitLab community edition, which is here, an open source software to collaborate on code. And here it is sign in and register. So I don't have a username and the password. And even we can also try for the directive brute forcing. But right now I'm not doing this thing. Okay. So let's try to register. Okay. With this. So I'm just going to give, okay, like a full name, which will be a hacker. Username I'll put, okay, like again, hacker 1234. Okay. Email I'll put, okay, again, hacker at the rate, suppose ha.com, hackerassociate.com. I use hacker at the rate hackerassociate.com. Okay, this is the domain, and the password I'll put, okay, same, hacker 1234. Okay, you can choose accordingly. depend upon the web application functionality. If application taking here, okay, like 20 character or 16 character like that, accordingly you need to create the password. It depend completely on web application. Right now, okay, like is not okay, like taking any other information. So what I have done is I simple taken a letter plus number, and you can choose accordingly. Now you can simple register here. So once you register, okay, with this, you can see clearly you're able to see lot of tabs, which you can see clearly. GitLab groups we have here, then activity, then we have a milestone, then we have a snippets. Now what we do next? So you can better, okay, you can try to explore, okay, this particular tab, each and every tab, and each and every information is very important to us. Now what I can do next here is I can simple go here and just go here to help. So when you simple go to the help button and then check it out, what exactly it is showing there. So I'm just waiting for the output, and you can clearly see it is called GitLab Community Edition, which is 11.4.7. okay, and you can see the version it displays, and second is it is getting a message here, update SF. So it means you have a version. Second, okay, like you're able to see clearly we need update here, update SF. So it may be look like a vulnerability. So what we can do here is I can go to the my new terminal and just go to the open a new terminal. So just type, okay, search exploit, and I can simple just try to check with this vulnerability called GitLab. So I'll copy that part. You can simple go to the terminal and then paste it. Control Shift plus V if you require shortcut. So when you press enter, you can see here, okay, we don't have any result. So clearly you can check here, right? When you just type search exploit, okay, you're not able to see any result here. Okay, so what you can do in the next here is you can simple just type search exploit again, and you can remove, okay, this part and then check it out. So here again, okay, like no success. What I can do, I can remove one more time. GitLab community is still not. So what I can do here is I can remove everything and then only put GitLab. And here you go. So you can clearly see, okay, like you have identified, okay, like some kind of payloads. Okay, vulnerability listed here. Basically, okay, like if you can check, this is the version GitLab 11.4.7, and here we have a RCE authenticated version. And if you can check, we have an arbitrary file. This is remote code execution authenticated. Okay, this is the like vulnerability, we can check it out. Okay, so what I can do next here is I need to explore, okay, this vulnerability, what exactly it is, how the code look like, and how we can exploit, okay, this particular vulnerability. Let us start. So again, what I can do, I can clear the screen. I can just simple just have once again this thing, and I create a one folder called mkdir, okay, temp. Okay, so I think I have a folder already there, temp ls, and you can see I have downloaded this particular payload, which is basically 49257.py, which is a remote code execution authenticated one. This is the actually I had downloaded. Now what I can do here, I need a sublime, and then we can simple open this particular payload, or you can use a liftpad. We have a 49257.py, press enter, and after that you can see clearly we have, okay, like this particular section available there. So you can see we require username, okay, which is written there, hacker 1234. You need to edit exactly the same, and we require authenticity token, and then we require cookie parameter, and then local port, and then local IP. So let's identify the local IP, and then we'll edit accordingly. So I'll go to my new tab and going to open a new tab here. Let's try to identify the IP address of our system. So our IP address is 10.10.14.4. Let me close, and I'll edit exactly 10.10.14.4, and I'll put a port 5555 as it is. And now we require, okay, this particular, these two section. Okay, by the way, username is hacker 1234. So this part is same as it is. Maybe in your case, it may be a different. What you can do here is you can edit accordingly that part. So now here, okay, we require two things: authenticity token and second is cookie parameter. So that parameter, how we can identify? So now I'm going to the browser again, and you can see there is a plus button here. You can see this is called new something. So you call new project. Let me hit this button. When you go to this particular tab, you can see we have a project name, project URL, projects. Select something here. So I'll okay, just type okay like new project, okay, and this part okay automatically I'll just change okay to the local host. Don't require any other thing. And if we can go to the import project, just check it out. You can see there are varieties of tabs are available there. And good thing is we have a Git repo by URL. So when you click here Git repo by URL, what you can do here is you can simply just type https. Then we have 127.0.0.1/. You can see if you read this information, like the repository must be accessible over HTTP, HTTPS, or Git. Second, if your HTTP repository is not publicly accessible, add authentication information to the URL. So you can see this sample is given there, this part, right? And whatever we require okay, like here dot git extension. So what I can do here is I can simply just type localhost dot git. Okay. And now project name. So project name, as we know, okay, like it's called new project. Here again, we'll put okay localhost, and we'll verify here first. So you can see it is a capital, and here also we have a capital. So new project, localhost. Description, if you want, you can put it here. Otherwise, you can simply create a project. But before hitting this button, we require the burp in between. So this is the burp intercept on, and then you can simply go here and create a project. So basically, the burp is a proxy, okay, is intermediate between client and server. Now I am going to intercept that request, okay, using this button called create project. So let's hit this one. So when you simply click here create project, and once again you can confirm okay intercept is on, and once you are done, you can simply just click here create project. You can see I just click on this, and when I go here, you can see this information came there. So we have an authenticity token which we require, and what you can do, you can copy from here to here. So let me once again, or you can simple first send to repeater, and from there, okay, you can copy. This is called send to repeater. This is a repeater tab, and let me drag this side. Okay, and I require this section. So carefully copy that part, which is basically up to 3D. And now you can decode this thing using Control Shift plus U. So Control Shift plus U. Okay, and that part, okay, you can copy. Fantastic. So here it is. You can copy. Once you copy that part, what you require is you can simple go to the Leafpad, and you can simple just go here and you can edit accordingly. So that part, okay, you can paste Command V, and I have added here. So you can see start with the QZ. Let me confirm again with the QZ something. It's QZO, and then ending with BKG equal to. Let me also confirm this thing again. BKG equal to. Fantastic. This part is done. Now we require cookie. This GitLab session. And also check it out in the burp. Where is the GitLab session? Which is here, basically here. So that part, okay, we need to copy accordingly. So you can copy that part. Okay, so copy, and then carefully you can go to the Leafpad, and from here, okay, you can paste it here accordingly. So it is done. Now this part as it is, we need to put, and we have a local port 5555, and this is our IP address. If everything okay, you can simple save the file. This is a save, and then you can simple close it. So once you're done with this particular part, you can simple cat it, and you can check, verify everything. Everything all right? So yes, it is all right. You can see when you read this particular code, it will give a system. You can see os.system, and it will bind the connection on this local particular port which you have given here, right? That IP and that port. here 10.10.14.4. So what I can do here is I can split horizontally this thing. And I can start listening on this. So NC minus L VVP 5555 is started. And now I am running okay this particular code, which is basically Python 3. And something like 49257. That's how we can run okay this particular exploit. When you press enter, if everything okay, you will be getting a connection. Fantastic. See, we got the connection here. So let me exit from this particular tab. And you can see clearly we got the connection. If you confirm okay using ID, you can see we have a UID 998. If you just type who am I think the typo error, who am I? You can see we have Git. Now what you can do here is you can simply just type Python 3 minus C single code import pty termination, then pty dot spawn bin bash, and then single code close. If everything okay, you'll be getting a prompt. Fantastic. And now if you just type clear command, it will not work here. See, we need to set this term environment variable. So what, how to do it? You can simply just type export and just type term equal to xterm. And now our environment variable is set. Now we can use clear command, it will work there. Fantastic. Now what we do next? So right now, okay, like see, we got a user privilege. Okay, now from that part, okay, we need to perform a privilege escalation. So we need to root this machine. So if you just have okay like ls, you can see there are many informations available there. And generally we need to identify the flag. Okay, this is called CTF, a particular part. So CTF, okay, you need to identify the flag. Basically, you can also type okay find slash minus name, okay, user.txt. So that flag, okay, you can easily identify using this particular command. So you can see this flag is under okay like home dude user.txt. You can simply copy that part and then you can simple get it, get control shift plus v. And you can see you have identified user.txt flag. Now next what we can do, how to perform a privilege escalation. So in order to perform a privilege escalation, what you need to do here is you need to first perform a proper enumeration. So once you perform a proper enumeration, then it's very easy for you, okay, to perform a privilege escalation. So let's see, okay, how we can do this particular thing in this particular machine. So let me just type clear again. And generally, I'll just go here cd command, I'll go complete out, and then check it out what are the folders are there. So I'll just go to the cd slash, and then if you can check ls, so we have opt, which is the third party, mnt for mount. So these informations are available there. Fantastic. So first what I can do here, I can check opt directory, because sometimes people use okay like you people generally download some software okay under the opt. So I'm just checking opt directory, and here you go. So we have a backup. Okay, let me check the directory or file ls minus ll. So you can see this backup, okay, is a directory, which you can see clearly is called D, the indicant directory. Then GitLab is also directory. So what I can do, I can simply go to cd backup and then ls. So first clear the screen. Okay, I am inside the backup directory, ls command. And you can see clearly we have a gitlab.rb. Okay, so even if you want, you can open this particular file. But generally what I am doing here is I can simply just type cat gitlab dot rb, and I'll put okay pipe and just try to grep and then pass. You can see like wherever the password is there, okay, is showing here, right? So you can clearly see I have a password right now. This is smtp password, which is here. And likewise, if you can read, okay, there are many passwords are available here. So what I can do here, I can simple copy that part, okay, and check the user. So cat slash etc slash passwd. So we have this user, and just try to use sudo minus l. So you can see like this command not giving any result. Now we have a password. Okay, what I can do, I can simply just type sudo space root and then press enter. And you can see require the password. What I can do now, I can simply just paste this particular password and then enter. Now you can clearly see you reach to the root level. Okay, this is called privilege escalation. So this is okay called as a vertical privilege escalation. It means from that user okay to the root. Okay, if it is the same level or within the same hierarchy, then okay we call as an horizontal privilege escalation. So now what we can do next? So here I think you have identified many thing. Okay, and let me just type clear command. Okay, but here okay if you just type cat command like slash root dot txt, that flag is not available here. Okay, so in this case okay like probably we are in the Docker container. So let me check okay what exactly we have information here. So I can simple just type fdisk minus l, and when you simple just type fdisk minus l, you can see clearly we have a three partitions here: SDA1, SDA2, SDA3. So SDA1 basically is a BIOS boot, and what we require here is we require Dev SDA2. But the problem is okay, like how to access this particular file system because we are in the Docker container. So in this case, okay, like I have a one option. Okay, like we can use a mount command. And before this, we require okay one directory. So let me create okay directory called mkdir, and go to the /temp/test. Okay, and when this part is done, I can simple mount the source. The source is okay, we have a dev and then sda2, and that part okay to where? To the temp and then test. Okay, that part is done. Fantastic. Now what I can do here is I can simple just type /temp then test. Inside this okay like we'll try to search for the root.txt. Let me try like that. So I can simple just go cd temp test ls, and now here it is our file system. Okay, we have mounted this is a particular file system. So I'll go to the cd, we have a root directory. Okay, then we have a ls. You can see clearly we have a root.txt basically here. I just have cat root.txt. You can see this is a root flag we have successfully identified. That's how okay you can approach the machine. Okay, so now we are able to access the entire file system, and basically this is called Docker container. Now if you want a permanent part, like example, let's say you want to connect to this machine anytime, so there's also one option. Okay, you can trigger it here. You can always look into this directory called as a .ssh directory, this part. Okay, and I think is available there. So if you can simple go to the cd.ssh, I'll go here and you can check it here what exactly it is. Here you go, you have a public key and then id rsa and then authorized keys are there. What I can do here is, because if you know ssh is a remote login protocol, by the way, 22 is a port number, even we'll create our own key, and that public key I'll copy okay into the authorized key, and from my private key I can directly log into this particular system. Okay, this also we can do here. So how we can achieve this section? So in this section, okay, like what I can do here is I can simple split my terminal horizontally, and I go to the my Kali terminal. Okay, which is, this is okay actually my attacker machine, and this is okay like victim, okay, which we have done root right now. Okay, so we successfully escalate the privilege and we identify whatever we require. Now I can simple go to my cd/root.ssh and then ls, and you can see clearly we have a id rsa.pub. So that part okay, like how we can do it. So simple, you can say type cat command id rsa.pub, and that part okay from here to here, okay, you can simple copy. Okay, and now you can simple using echo command, you can simple paste it here. So I just type okay like echo single quote control shift v and then single quote close, and then append this file, append this particular okay like public key to here, like authorized key. So I simple just type authorized authorized underscore keys. Check the spelling properly. If everything okay, will append here. So I think it is done. Now you can see what will happen. Okay, next. So here it is my Kali machine, and I can simply just type SSH. Okay, and I'll use my private key and log into this machine, and you can see clearly it is working and fantastic. We have rooted the machine successfully. Now you can simply just type ls, and you can see directly we can see root.txt. So now we are able to access the entire file system, okay, because we have copied our public key directly. Before, what we have done is we have mounted, and then okay, like we have checked this particular flag. This is how okay you can approach okay like application penetration testing. It means this is how you can approach the application, and you can perform penetration testing on that. So generally in my advanced web application pen testing class, okay, like I am okay doing this kind of lab, okay, like all real world scenario, whatever the industry people are using, like example, it's a Bubsy Professional, Net Sparker, Equinetex, all software, okay, whatever we are using in industry, that all licensed software I am going to deliver, okay, in this particular training. And this is a high end training, is not a normal training, and is one of the best, okay, like my like penetration testing, which I am okay doing okay on a public application. So in this training, okay, like I'll focus more and more public application as well as labs. So like this kind of lab we are performing first before jumping on okay, to the public application. So we require a little bit basics first. You need to finish. For example, you should know how to do a reverse connection, how to create an account on Amazon. It means because sometimes we require Amazon, AWS, okay, Azure, because we require public IP address. So you have a two option. You can use ngRoc or you can go to the Azure or AWS. There are many okay like thing okay you can do. You can create a malware and you can inject okay into the particular remote system and you can get a reverse connection back. So this kind of technique okay we are going to learn okay in this our advanced web application pen testing. So it is a real hands-on training, and I'm going to cover more than 80 plus vulnerabilities, and I'm going to cover everything like how to use Bubsuit, how to use OSPZAP, how to use NetSparker, how to use a Kali, how you can integrate okay like the entire Kali okay to the Bubsuit or the Zap, automated okay like penetration testing, and then okay like script based pen testing. So script based means okay like example, let's say if you want to perform okay like course vulnerability or like SSRF identification vulnerability related stuff okay you want to do, so how you can automate this particular thing. So that all part okay we are covering okay in this particular section. That's all for this video. I hope this video is informative for you. Thank you for watching the video. Have a great day.